Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we are going to build a simple user CRUD using React hooks. So in previous set of videos we have already covered what all different hooks we can use to manage the state and to perform some kind of a side effect. Okay, so we will be using all those concepts and we will try to build a very simple application which can look something like this. It's a data table and where you can actually do the user CRUD operation. Okay, so we are not targeting very big initially. We are targeting a small thing like user CRUD with hooks. Then we will build some complex application also, like maybe Netflix clone or anything else. Okay, so first let's cover this application. What we are doing is we are starting with very basic setup. Here is our very basic application. Now, what we need to build this is we need a user table component, and you can see add user form component. So this can be independent component which is creating a new user, and there can be one parent component to which you are sending event. Okay, like add user, edit user, form, and then this can be user table. If you are editing the user, then we will be populating the edit user form. If you are creating new user, then we will be populating new user form, or you can manage both the cases in a single form by populating the values. Okay, so what we are going to do to make it more simple, let's have a two forms initially, edit user form and add user form. When you click on edit, then edit user form will populate the initial user information which you already have. And we are going to have a local state, so when you reload, data will go away. That is fine. Okay, so we can actually create the components, required components here. So we need the forms and we need one table component. Table, we will be creating a user table. So this is usertable.js, and in the form we can create two. Add user.js, and there can be another component which is edit user. Okay, now how we are going to structure them, both these components on app.js. First of all, how we are going to populate the user information and how we are going to change them. So we know that how to use state hook. Here we are going to maintain our user data. So what we can do is initially let's mock some data, const user. So it's an array of object. So here we can say id1, name something, and we have another field is username. Anything you can add, like two or three fields. Okay, this is my dummy data which I wanted to populate. Now I can do is I can initialize my initial state. Okay, so I can use hooks here, const user or set user. Set users, let's call it users. Okay, and I'm initializing this with the data which we have. So I'm using use state hook and I'm initializing that with dummy user data which we have for initialization. Okay, so initially this is the user data I already have. Okay, I will start pushing the data. Okay, and current user, so we are not editing any user initially on the initial screen. We will see these empty text fields. Okay, so we can have another state which is current user. So whenever you edit a particular row, then we should be able to set that user as a current user. Current user, and here I can say set current user, and in the current user we will have initial data. So here I can have initial state also. Let me just make it one liner. So this is the initial state I have in the user list. Then we can have one more thing is current initial user data. And what this user data is, ID is null. I mean, everything is null initially when you are actually not doing anything. And we have this initial user data we are setting in the use state. Okay, this is the current user data. Now we can have other attributes, like when you click on edit, then we have to do the set editing true so that we can switch between these two forms, add user and edit user. So for that also we can have one is set editing and set editing. And initially this will be false. So if editing is false, in the render method we can decide what we are going to render. Okay, if editing is true, then we will show edit user form. If editing is false, we will hide it. So we can actually use some kind of basic JSX here just to make our code look good. This is the closing. Okay, just indent it. Okay, now in the flex large, it's actually the main banner screen. Here we can check if editing is true, it means we are actually rendering the edit form component. If that is not the case, then we will be rendering add user form, right? Here you can actually write your fragments. So in fragment you can say edit user, so we should know that what we are doing. So it is edit user initially, and then we have next one is add new user. Based on this condition, it should be inside fragment. So we can just create a dummy fragment, so we don't need to introduce any div tag. Okay, now we will be having one component which is edit user form. We can render it here, and here we will have add user form, and we can create these two components somewhere in our add user and edit user. Okay, so these are going to be a basic HTML form. Okay, and we are going to write a functional component. Okay, so we can actually copy a few things from here itself. So this is add user and this is edit user. So in add user, this will represent some kind of a form, so we'll convert it into that. So we don't need a container. Container is already there. So this form, and here we are going to have a few text fields. Text field means we will have a basic HTML form which will have a label and input text field. Okay, and this is the form where we will be submitting the form. So here I can actually make this is add user form. Okay, this is will be here we will be accessing the props because this is a child component, and in this form we are going to have a label and all these things. Label is equal to name, and then we will have another label which is username. Okay, after this we can have input text field. Input text field is user.name. Okay, now I can just copy the same thing for both. Here it is name and here it is username. Okay, now what initial state we are going to have is, initial state for this add user is our username and password will be empty. Okay, so if username and password is empty, then we can actually update the state. So initial state is id null and user end. So what we can do is, here we are populating name and username. So whenever you do on change, what we can do is you can actually set the state. So here we can have one method handle change. Okay, handle change method, same method we can use for another text field, so that whenever you are typing anything in this text field, I will be able to capture the value coming out from this text field. Handle change, we just have a name attribute, it's name, and this is username, and I can write one method which is handle change, so that will take care of updating the state. So this is const handle change, and we are writing arrow function, so you don't need to do this. We can simply write handle change. In class based component we can use this particular trick, const handle change, and we can write the arrow function here itself, and here we will be getting event object. Based on that we can actually update the state. Okay, so here from the event we can get both the things, name and value, and we are getting this from the e.target. Okay, now we can actually call set user, and in the set user we can pass, so this is my current user, and what I'm updating is I'm updating this name value pair. Okay, this is fine. So whenever you are typing either name and password, you will be able to capture both the values. Okay, so now we just need to add a submit method. After submit method, I think most of our task will be done. We are actually submitting a data from this form, and once we send the data to the parent component, we will be able to access the values from here. Okay, so similarly we are going to write an event form. So this is initial state of the user form. Similarly, we can actually use the edit user form. We'll just change it to add to edit. This is add user form. What else is left is, okay, we need to add on submit method. On submit will be, we can say handle submit. This kind of logic we have already written at various places, different places. Okay, now in the handle submit, what we can do is we can just think about all different kind of validation which we can put. Here first of all, we have to stop the propagation, first prevent default, so that we are not submitting the form, we are actually passing the values. Prevent default, okay, now we can just check both the values, we got the username, user.name and user.username. If we have both the values, then we are good. Then here in this case we can call the parent component method props.addUser, and we can pass the user object. Okay, and once the user is submitted, we can actually set the user with initial state, because now we have to make our form empty. Set user with initial state. Okay, same thing we can replicate on edit user form. Now what we are doing is, from this particular form we are sending the captured values from the form, event.preventDefault, user.name, props.addUser. Okay, so we are getting one property from the parent component, which is addUser. Okay, now what we can do is we can import this component into app.js. Here add user form, import add user from, and this is forms add user. Fine, and here in the add user form we are actually getting the one props. We have to take care of the add user, so we'll call the add user method here. Okay, now with this add user we can define here this add user method, and what we'll be doing add user is it will be updating the user data. It will be just adding the new user to the state. So we have this users array, we'll be updating this on the add user. So we can just set the user.id. So currently if you see, we have initialized the user data with this user data id. So currently this is the first id. What we can do is we can increment it, user.id equal to users.length plus 1. We're actually setting the user id, and we already have the users.length plus 1, and now we can do set users. This we are actually setting the new data for the users. So what we can do is the current set of users, we are spreading that and we are passing the new user object. This is just a way of concatenating the two array. This is the array and this is already existing array. So we are concatenating them. So we should be able to get the users. I mean, users are now updated. Now you can pass the new set of users to the user table. User table can be another component where we will be actually printing all the user information from with the help of table. Here I think we can add this. So we can create another component which is a user table. Inside table we have a user table component. This will be just doing nothing but displaying user information. So here we are passing the users, whatever we have, and we will be getting two methods, addItUser, addItRow, and we can also get a deleteUser, because from the table you can do two things, deleteUser or addItUser. Now this component should be straightforward, deleteRow or addItRow and deleteRow, we can say. DeleteRow means delete user itself. Delete user, edit user. Okay, so user table component will be just showing the user information in the table and sending two different events. Okay, so I will just, this is a user table. I already have this component handy. I can push it. So from the profs, we are actually receiving these users. So here you can see I am passing the user's information. So I can access this user using this dot props dot user in the user table. This dot props dot user, I mean, we are writing functional components, so we can access directly using props dot users. We are iterating on it, and for every row inside a table we have these two buttons, edit row and delete. So it will also be delete user. It should be edit user. Let's make it same, and we are passing the user object. This is fine. Here we are passing id. Okay, we are getting the ID, we are passing ID. So delete user and edit user. Edit user and delete user. Here we are getting the index. So we can define both these methods. So this is delete row. Here it should be edit user. Sorry, edit row, which will be just updating one particular state. I mean, it will be just setting current user. So we have delete row and edit row. Edit row will just set the current user to that particular user object which we have set, so that that user can be edited. So here you can see we can do set editing true, means we are now going to render edit form, and in this particular case set editing set current user we will be calling. In set current user, we will be updating the current user data. Okay, current user is initial data is this. Okay, we will update this to the new data we are getting. So we are actually getting the user in the payload, user object while doing edit. So here we will set that this user is ready to get edited. So user.name, user.username. Once you understand the flow, writing the React components are very easy. Now this is a delete user. Delete user, you can say here I'm doing set editing false, because we are actually deleting user, and set users. Here we can just simple filter the existing users. Set users, users dot filter, and we will return only those users whose IDs doesn't match with the ID which we have received in the delete call. So here I can say user.id should not be equal to the ID which we have received, return only those, and it is being set, right? Set user, this is again an array, and we are initializing user data with an array, so data is updated. Delete row, similarly we can have an update row that is same as update user that we will be getting from the edit form. Update row, in the update row we'll get the ID and the new payload. I mean, for this particular ID I wanted to update user, and I will be sending some data. So set editing will be false, and then set users. So what we will do is, first we will find out which particular user you are updating. Okay, so here with this condition we can get it. If the user you wanted to update, if we are able to find it, what we will do is, if this condition is matched, then for that particular user, we can just update the attributes. Okay, so what we can do is, okay, we can just directly return updated user here. Otherwise, we will just return user. So what I'm saying is, if the condition is match, then return this new object. Otherwise, return the existing object for rest of the IDs. So it is fine. So we actually created this. Now we can actually take care of this math set edit user form, because here we are getting these two attributes from this particular form, update row. Sorry, update user is being called from child component, and we are calling this update row. So if you just go to edit user form, this is our edit user form. So in the edit user form, what we are doing is, when you are actually clicking on submit, okay, when you are clicking on to the submit button, we are just checking username is passed, password is passed. First of all, how we are going to populate both the fields with the predefined set of users, that we have to see, because we will be getting the data from the props. Okay, so instead of initializing it, we will be getting the props.currentUser. If you see this, we will be passing this current user. Once you have set the editing, then this current user will be passed to this edit form. Current user equal to this. So we can actually populate the current law of the user which is going to be updated with this current user. Now if you go to edit user form, we can actually declare it on the top. I mean, this is going to be lengthy, but this is pretty much interesting how we are doing it. Forms, and here we are doing edit user. So we are passing two things, current user and updated user. So current user you can access, current user has all the properties. So I am initializing my user with the current user itself. So I already have user.user and user.username properties. Okay, and when you are actually submitting, then we will be just passing this payload with ID. So here we will be submitting, we will be just checking. You don't need to check, because you can just update the username. So here we will be just calling props.updateUser. Props.updateUser. Here we will be passing user.id and the updated user object. Okay, so here we are already having handle change. Handle change will update the user object with the key value pair which you are entering. It is initialized with the value which we have received from the parent component. Props.currentUser. This user is initialized with that value. Now, when you click on to this handle submit, what we are doing is, we are calling update user. We already have a user ID and the updated user object. Okay. So what other things we can do here is, whenever this props is getting updated, so this is the one time, right? But what if you keep editing multiple users? Then we have to set this current user, because this will execute only once. In this particular case, this user property is not getting reset. So what we have to use is use effect callback, and use effect will refresh this user object if new props are coming from the parent component. So whenever the props is getting updated, we will just call set user with the props.currentUser, and we are not doing anything for the cleanup, so I will just return it. This, why we need this? So initially you got the props, you assigned it to the current user, we are able to show the user in the form. Now you go to add user form, and now coming back again, then component is already rendered, we just toggled it, right? So then again you just need to populate this. So in that case, we always need to check if props is getting changed. Then we have to update the current user, because you can click on edit multiple times and you can populate the multiple user informations here. So this is the safest way of doing it. Okay, so we have our application ready. What we did is very basic things. We are populating, we are doing CRUD operation, updating user, deleting user, adding new user. Add user is just a push, delete is just a filter, update is just updating the user object based on the new payload. Edit row means we are just editing as a true false, toggling it, and we are just setting current user with wherever you have clicked edit. Okay, so that we are getting from this user table. From user table, if you clicked on edit user, we are sending the user payload. If you are deleting it, we are just sending ID so that user can be deleted based on the filter. Okay, very basic, but this is interesting to understand the use state, use effect, how we can manage the state with the hooks. We are not writing classes, it's all functional component we have written. Now we can run this application and see. Okay, now we can move to next application. Before that, I will show this running. Thanks everyone.